sorry, brothers and sisters, Talofa. We'd like to welcome you to the service today. We are gathered together to celebrate our mom's life. Presiding over this service today would be Bishop Wise and conducting this meeting. I am the son of married to Mrs. Wong. Our chorister today will be Alipa Longlongo, and the pianist will be Yunita Sari. I'm gonna apologize in advance. I think I'm gonna push over someone, so please bear with me. I'll probably be renaming a couple of you guys, so please forgive me for that. Our opening hymn will be hymn number 181, and our invocation will be offered by Vanine, doing a model with the knees. Just a couple of announcements. We have a program with the door right in the back over there. And if you could please silence your phones. And if you want to use the restrooms, it's through the door over there, and there's another one from here. And also, just a few announcements. All these speeches will be up the wall. You guys could, like, please just leave it on the wall. And don't get them off, please. So we'll start the program. We'll start with the opening game.
So grateful and grateful for the atonement, as well as the plan of happiness. to the companies can be together for Alzheimer's Day. As they have the power to help us to remember the life of our ancestors and save these things in the name of thy Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Now we'll hear our eulogy from father-in-law of my mother, his brother. And following father-in-law, we'll have a speaker. Mom of my mother, his uncle. And then following that, we'll have a speaker, Sue Green, who is a sister. And then we'll have memories from Yusefa, Ines, and Paliva. They are nieces and nephews.
They were a big part of the Afrimantes migrating from Samoa to the U.S. When I get myself here, I held Afrimantes title as a retired member of the family. Lucy was the seventh of 12 children. Her name was given from a friend to her mother who had no children. And with my older sister, Michelle, and then we had three siblings that passed away, Paul, and my sister Marcella that passed away. And we have my sister Marcella that's living at Bayonetta today. And then there was me, my two older, my brother Michael. Then there was Lucy, me, Talioa. There was Frank, Rahina, Sero Befa, and Suga. Her relationship with them was tempered throughout their younger days and treasured as they got older. The siblings have many stories about Lucy's, stories that you will hear from them later tonight. In the 70s, Lucy attended the Kahuku High School. As a first generation third grader in the seventh grade, she caught the eye of one Peter Collins. They became high school sweethearts, but went their separate ways later on to enjoy their senior year. Lucy probably graduated from Kahuku with the class of 1979, and later moved to Southern California. As Lucy dated around, she found true love again with Pico, as his love and service won over her heart. Peter and Lucy Collins were married September 11, 1982, in Compton, California. A marriage that started with a bang as the aunties had to lay hands and bless the guy that delivered the cake because the cake was late. They were later sealed for time and all eternity, December 3rd, in the Los Angeles. The Collins had six children, Nephi, Tanya, Pika Jr., Missiona, Oriana, and Telio. Lucy would dedicate her life to her children, sacrificing their schooling and career to raise them. Her favorite scripture was Proverbs 22:6. Train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. She truly gave all her all to them. If they were wrong, she never hesitated to correct them. If you did them wrong, it didn't matter who you were or where she found you, she would not hesitate to correct you. I believe the youth of today remember her as a real one. In 1993, they moved to Hawaii, residing in Kalihi, Kaula, and finally Lahaina. They were also taken to the Kalawasa of the day to honor Pika's family. In Hawaii, they could rely on the extended family and community to help take care and influence the kids in their upbringing. Lucy was proud to see all six of her grandchildren graduate as second generation.